Hello everyone, myself Ms. Shrutali Pilankar. I am working as a lecturer at IIP Sadavali College. Here we discuss about the topic that is introduction of pharmacognosy. So the learning outcome of this topic that includes history of pharmacognosy. Here we discuss about in detail what is the basic history of pharmacognosy. Then we will discuss in detail about the contribution of various scientists in the development of pharmacognosy. Then we will discuss the definition of pharmacognosy, and lastly we discussed on about scope of pharmacognosy. So here it is, the introduction of pharmacognosy. So pharmacognosy, the nature always stands on outstanding phenomena of symbiosis. That is, the biotic and abiotic element of nature are interdependent on each other. The history of herbal medicine is as old as human civilization. The documents, many of which are of great antiquity, and reveal that plants were used medicinally. India worked meticulously to examine and classify the herbs. Okay, so along with China and other countries, the India works on the herbs. Okay. A large portion of Indian population depends on Ayurveda and ancient science of life. As we know that Ayurvedic system of the medicine, which generally depends on the crude drugs, that is herbs. So here we discuss in detail about the major role of scientists. So first, that is Hippocrates, scientist, which is known as father of medicine. The next, Aristotle, Dioscorides, Galen, which made progress in the medicinal science. Galen, which is an first pharmacist. Sadler coined the term as a pharmacognosy. J. Chidmit wrote the Lehrberg, the Materia Medica. And F. A. Flückiger described the most comprehensive scope of pharmacognosy. So these are the some scientists. Here it is first, that is Hippocrates, then Aristotle, then Dioscorides, Swedelinius, Galen, which is a first pharmacist, and Sushruta. Okay, so Sushruta, its work on the Ayurvedic system and the herbs. So this is a definition of pharmacognosy. In 19th century, the term Materia Medica was used for the subject now known as pharmacognosy. Okay, so in 19th century, instead of pharmacognosy, the term Materia Medica is used. It was Sadler, a German scientist, who coined the term pharmacognosy in 1815 in the title of his work, that is Analecta Pharmacognostica. So pharmacognosy is derived from the two Greek word, pharmakon means drug and gignosko means to acquire the knowledge of. Means pharmacognosy is nothing but the knowledge acquirement of drug. So in detail, definition of pharmacognosy may be defined as the branch of bioscience which treats in detail the medicinal and related product of crude and primary type obtained from the plant, animal and mineral origin. So pharmacognosy, it is nothing but it is a branch of bioscience which treats in detail medicinal and related product of crude and primary type, which is obtained from the plant, animal and mineral sources. In short, it is an objective study of crude drug from natural sources treated scientifically, and it encompasses the knowledge of history, distribution, cultivation, collection, processing for market and preservation. The study of sensory, physical, chemical and structural characters and the uses of crude drugs. So all these phenomena comes under the pharmacognosy. So here it is, a major scope of pharmacognosy, that is pharmacognosy include as an applied science, has played a crucial role in development of different discipline of science. Okay, so different branches of science that co-currently independent on the pharmacognosy branch. Okay, thank you for the listening. Thank you.